Let's get stock specific now. Marico reported a mixed set of earnings for second quarter, while consolidated EBITDA and profit saw growth year on year, margins saw a sharp contraction. Saugata Gupta, the MD and CEO of Marico, joins us now to discuss more on the earnings fine print. Mr. Gupta, good afternoon. Thank you so much for joining us. Well, Q2 saw growth both on a quarter on quarter and on a YY basis. But what is the prognosis you have for demand and revenue recovery going forward?
We are now going to lap a very high base of 15% and 25%, 24-25% volume growth in the second half. I think while the trends are looking okay, except for the fact that there we have seen some slowdown in rural. Now, I think it's too early to call it a slowdown. I think there has been a, what I call a moderation of growth that has happened sometime towards the end of the quarter. Having said that, I think it is also a function of two, three things, I would say. One is inflation. And the second thing is the fact that there are a lot of opening up happening. So therefore, there is a pent-up demand in other, you know, consumption categories, and therefore a combination of inflation and diversion of consumption towards other categories could have had an impact. I think it's, as I said, it's too early to call this as a slowdown or something, but there has been a moderation of growth. I believe that the monsoon has been good. There has been significant, continues to be significant benefits that accrue to the rural segment of the population. So we have to wait and watch. But I believe that in the second half, we should be able to deliver mid-single digit growth. And we'll see if things don't deteriorate, then that growth rate could, you know, keep on creeping up as we move towards the quarters going forward.
Now that's an interesting point that you're making, Saugata, that rural is seeing a bit of a slowdown. So how much does rural account for in your overall sales, and what's the growth rate versus urban?
So rural, as I said, continued. See, the rural growth was higher than urban even this this quarter. But what we saw is a little bit of slowing down that happened towards the end of the quarter. And so, as I said, it's too early. But I think given the fact that we are also lapping very high growth rates in the second half, we're having a little wait and watch. Having said that, as I said, that most of the drivers of growth, whether the diversification journey on foods, the discretionary items, which are doing far better, so all that is in place. So I think it's too early to, you know, think about it as a slowdown. We're just being a little cautious, that's all.
So, Mr. Gupta, that's about demand, but let's talk about margins now. Gross margins have improved on a quarter-on-quarter basis, and they are likely to improve further too. What levels are you seeking there?
So, I think it's difficult to give a number. The way I look at it is it's that there will be sequential improvement in gross margins going forward. If you look at the two, three components of the gross margin, the firstly, of course, is the copra, which is now moderated, and it will be range bound in the coming quarters. So that's sorted. Having said that, I think the vegetable oil and crude based, whether it's in packaging or raw material, continues to be high. So I think and that more, that lowering can only happen most likely earliest could be in Q4. So I think what we will do is the It should start sequentially improving. I see sequential improvement happening every quarter. But going back to a more 2020 levels, I would call it. Let us not look at 2016 level. That could have been a year where everything was in deflation. But that will gradually come back in the next two, three quarters. As far as EBITDA is concerned, however, since some of the cost initiatives which you have again putting in place, the accruals will come in Q4, plus the fact that in the second half of the year, with discretionary coming up, opening, and also the economy opening, and also to support some of our innovations, our A&P spends will be a tad higher in the second half than first half. So I see the EBITDA margin improving only from Q4 onwards, and it will, I guess, gradually go back to the 19% plus in the following quarters.
All right, 19% plus in terms of EBITDA margins following Q4. Importantly, you're looking at 2020 levels for the gross margins. Over the next 2 to 3 quarters, 2020 average levels were closer on 48 to 49 odd percent. You did 42.5% right now. But the big point, the trigger is new products. You've had a slew of innovations. How much do they account for in your overall sales? How is that likely to go ahead, Saugata?
Let me not just give you just a number, but to give you some idea, I think the food journey is very much on track. We are extremely confident of delivering a 500 crore turnover this year. And then obviously we have an aspiration to hit at 850 to 1000 crore food by 2024. The digital business is tracking well. I think we have a job to do in premiumizing of our hair nourishment business, where I think we are today underrepresented, and that's something we need to deliver over the next 12 to 24 months.
Well, Mr. Gupta, you sound optimistic. You're talking about gross margins inching higher, second half of this year also to be very strong. But, you know, the street refuses to increase the valuation multiple on Marico because they're not too sure of companies' execution capabilities. What are your thoughts on that?
So I think we focus on giving sustainable, profitable growth. Our focus is on doing the right things. And obviously, I think our diversification track record, especially on food today, is definitely significantly improved. And we are extremely confident of delivering that. There are four drivers of our diversification. In India, it is obviously food followed by digital brands. I think premiumization of hair nourishment and some of the discretionary categories which got impacted by COVID, which was serums and male grooming. Now, serums has come back to pre-COVID levels. Male grooming is improving. We have a job to do in the premiumization of hair nourishment. In the international business, I think Bangladesh is has a proven track record of diversification of journey and delivering, you know, double-digit constant currency growth. International business, actually, all the economies are stable. We are delivering very, very stable and consistent numbers. So I think we focus on actually, as I said, that predictability of growth, driving diversification of our portfolio, ensuring that we are aggressive on all cost management and managing inflation. The multiples is a derived thing. I think our focus is more on growth and delivering things which continue to be sustainable and, you know, predictable.
Well, if you sustainably and predictably continue to grow, you know, the street will perhaps go ahead and increase those multiples as well. This is now for you to go ahead and execute. And on that execution itself, you spoke about digitization and digital brands. You acquired Just Herbs. What are the plans for Just Herbs? And in D2C itself, what are the other acquisitions that you're looking at?
Obviously, I think we are mindful of the inflation. I think inflation has an impact in a long term, medium short term, I would call it, in terms of consumption trends, because I think the inflation, especially whether it's crude and other factors, can lead to some kind of a moderation and consumption trends. Secondly, obviously, as far as the, I think while food is it's on a very, very solid track. I think some of the other innovations, we have a job to do, and that will take some time. And I think, therefore we have to execute that well. And I think once we do that, I think the good thing is the core business is very much on a solid footing. And similarly, some of the international businesses, I think we have to ensure that we open up the next pillar of growth. And towards that, we have already started our journey in expanding the total addressable market. We have launched now Saffola Oats in Middle East. We have launched hair oils in Egypt. So that journey also needs to go, because currently I think a significant part of the growth was being led by Bangladesh.
Mr. Gupta, thank you so much for joining us. It was a pleasure speaking with you. So that's the word coming in from Marico. With that, we'll slip into a short break. It's all about consumption today. Amit Jatia, Vice Chairman, Westlife Development, will be joining us on the other side to discuss